Yes. Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
So, in the previous class, we have finished physics, unit 4. Okay. Now, we will go for the chemistry, unit 4. What is the lesson here?
Physical and chemical changes.
What do you understand by the word physical change?
Temporarily.
Temporarily change.
Physical means temporary change and correct is reversible. Okay. And what about chemical change?
It will not change.
Cannot be reversed, it is irreversible and it is a permanent change.
For example, milk to curd.
Milk to curd, we have new substances. Okay. In the chemical reaction, we will get some new substance. Okay. Whereas in physical substance, new substance is not, may not form, may form. Okay. But the properties will not be changing here. For example,
ice to water,
it changes only state from solid to liquid. But the taste of water, but the color of water does not change at all. Yes or not?
Yes.
So that means physical change takes place only temporary purpose. Only temporary. Whereas chemical change takes place permanently. Okay. For example, burning of candle is a physical change or chemical change?
Physical.
It's a chemical change. Why? Because you are burning of the wax. Where is the wax moving on?
Melting.
So that process, can you get back the wax again?
Yes, no. Ma'am.
How? Okay. but new substance is not produced where the chemical properties will be changing. Clear? We have discussed about water to ice. The properties of water does not change, only state changes. Okay, whereas in chemical change, one more example is making of milk to curd. There you have obtained a hard substance. Milk is a liquid, whereas solid, curd is a semi-solid. And you have got different taste also. It contains a lot of bacteria in curd. That means a new substance is evolved in the curd. So therefore, that type of thing is called as chemical change. From the curd, you cannot get milk again. Whereas from the
milk, we can make curd.
From the physical change. That means from the water, we can give again ice. Okay. Next. So here, physical change is a change that evolves only a change in a physical state of matter. Only physical change for looking purpose, by seeing either it changes its color, okay, or its shape, or its matter, that is its state, either liquid to gas, gases to liquid or solids. Okay, next. Characteristics of physical change. First thing, characteristics means physical change takes place when temperature increase or decrease. Physical change takes place either the temperature may increase or
decrease.
If temperature increases, what happens? It forms into vapor, water. Example. Okay. If temperature increases, if you give more amount of heat, what happens?
Gaseous.
It forms into gaseous form. That is, water vapor is evolved. Okay. If we cool it, what happens? If it increases the temperature,
ice.
What happens?
It becomes solid.
It becomes solid. That is ice. Okay. If we give temperature high or decrease, physical change occurs. Okay. Whereas chemical change, if you take give heat, what happens? New substance is
formed.
Next. In one word, physical changes are reversible. That means we can get the components after change also. Okay. What are the components we are using in the starting before change? We will get the same components if we reverse it. Okay. Can you get rice from a cooked rice?
No, no ma'am.
So which type of change is it?
Chemical change.
Yes. Next. So here are some examples of chemical, physical changes. First is change of state.
Mixture.
Change of state. And next is formation of mixture. And next one is a change in shape by size. Here are some of the examples of the physical change of characteristics. Change of states. In physical change, it changes to, it may change its state. Okay. From liquids to
gases.
Okay, from solid to liquid. Can it happen directly from solids to gaseous?
Yes, ma'am.
No. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Sublimation. The process of changing from solids directly into solids gaseous is called as
sublimation.
What is the example here?
Camphor.
Camphor is the best example.
Naphthalene balls.
Okay, naphthalene balls, camphor, they both are the best example. If the heat just outside, they react with the air and they just form into gaseous. Okay, and if we want to collect it, if I put lid over the camphor and if we heat it, we can see the flames of camphor and then we attaching to the lid of the camphor bulb. Okay, and we can collect the camphor again. That type of mixture also called as physical change. Okay, here we are increasing the temperature.
Camphor is a physical change.
Camphor is a physical change.
After evaporating,
we have to collect it. We keep a lid over the camphor dish. Whatever it is, vapors are coming outside, they will be attached to the lid. And if you remove that from the, if you remove from the lid, then it is called as camphor. Clear? Next. Formation of mixture. See, for example, mixing of rice and stone is a physical change or chemical change?
Physical change.
Physical change, because you can remove the stones. In the same way, in the water, if you mix salt or sugar, which chemicals?
Chemicals.
water will be evaporated and what will be left under the
salt
will be left in the cup. Okay, this is what how we are getting salt from the seawater. Yes or not?
No.
So formation of mixture also because it is also a what change?
Physical change.
Okay, next change in shape and size. If we put
ice,
take an ice cube. Its shape is a square or whatever we put it in.
Cube.
Okay,
cube.
Put it outside.
On a table.
It melts. There the shape is changing or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Size is changing?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Both are changing. So they both are again physical properties of the physical change. For example, pour the water in the bottle. It acquires a bottle shape.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Pour this water in the bowl.
The change
has happened from bottle to the bowl, but property does not change. Only the shape has changed. Even size also same. Okay, this is a chalk piece. If I break it, what happens? Two chalk pieces will be forming. Yes or not? So I have break. Is it change there? Will the chalk piece lose its power to write?
No, ma'am.
No. So here are some of the examples of the physical changes. Change of state. From liquids to
gases,
or from solids to liquids.
Yes.
Okay. Next, formation of mixture. It can be any substance in the water.
Salt solution.
Water solution. We can collect. We can it again. Okay. Change in shape and size. It also temporarily change.
Okay.
Water.
Water.
Now, what is chemical change? Chemical change is a permanent change. It may or may not get its original compositions, original components.
May or may not.
Not exactly. Okay. But whereas it is evolving, it is released in each and a new substance is obtained. Clear everyone? In physical change, new substance is not obtained. Though it is obtained, it has the same characteristics of the original substance. In chemical change, new substance is obtained. Here is it from milk to curd, you have obtained a new substance or not? Yes? See, do you know in summer you will get good milk, good curd? Yes? And in less time you will get curd. Whereas in winter it takes a lot of time to make curd. It takes 1 day, 24 hours. Why?
Because hard.
Because here that milk requires heat conditions. Yes? That means it absorbs heat. Then only it takes form the bacteria. Clear? That is a chemical changes where chemical compositions include in it. Next, burning of paper is physical change or chemical change?
Chemical change.
After burning, what will get?
Ash.
So, is it a new component? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you write an ash now?
No.
So, new composition is obtained as well as new property is also obtained. Clear? So, it is a chemical changes. Next. In a chemical change, a new substance is formed. Okay. Next thing, on reversing the condition, the original substance may or may not form. On reversing it, the original substance may form or may not form. Because that means it is irreversible. Next, in chemical change, the chemical and physical properties of a substance formed will be different from the original substance. As we have discussed, milk to curd and paper to ash, these both are different from the milk and the paper. Yes or not? Curd is different from the milk, paper is different from the ash. So they both are different from the water product we have used before the change. Clear? Next is examples of chemical changes. Here are some examples. These are the examples of physical change. Now examples of chemical change.
Burning of magnesium river.
Magnesium river. That is also a chemical change.
Explosion of fireworks is a chemical change.
Ribbon. Explosion of fireworks.
Explosion of fireworks.
Spoiler food. here. These are examples of what? Chemical
changes.
Burning of magnesium ribbon. Do you know magnesium ribbons? Okay. If that ribbon is burnt, what is obtained? An ash is obtained. Okay. That means when magnesium ribbon is off, magnesium is burnt in the air, that means it takes oxygen and it uses up magnesium oxide, that is ash. That ash is nothing but it is a magnesium oxide. Clear everyone? That means it takes two substances. On heating, it forms magnesium oxide. Okay, these two are called as reactants. Okay, and this is called as chemical reaction. Understand what is chemical reaction?
Yes.
Chemical reaction is nothing but is a mixing of two chemicals to obtain one more substance. Okay, it is an interconversion of the two substances. Magnesium is reacted with the oxygen. It is burning in the air. It consumes. It takes oxygen to give out magnesium oxide. This is a reaction. Okay, this is a chemical reaction where it loses the chemical property. Clear? The substance which undergo chemical reaction are called as
reactants.
Okay, the substance which form into new substance or chemical reaction, they are called as reactants. And the process is totally called as magnesium oxide. This is the thing what we have obtained. Clear? So here, what are reactants? Oxygen as well as magnesium. So, burning of magnesium oxide in air gives out magnesium oxide. Clear everyone?
So here, magnesium and oxygen are called as
magnesium and oxygen are called as reactants. Okay. And this full reaction is called as
reaction.
Chemical reaction. Chemical reaction. Okay. Next. Explosion of fire crackers is also best example of chemical reaction. Do you burn fire crackers?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the word if you burn crackers?
Pollution.
Pollution. Smoke. Yes. They are not good for the health also. Yes or not? So, as smoke is evolved, pollution is evolved, from that pollution and smoke, can you get crackers or chemicals again?
No, ma'am.
No. So, if fire crackers doing that, they will use a chemical.
Yes, ma'am.
When that chemical reacts with the, what?
Fire.
Fire. That is light, heat. Then it starts explosion. That means it is also a chemical reaction or not?
Yes,
chemical reaction is taking place there.
Yes,
that heat will be mixing with the chemical, then it starts explosion. Clear everyone? Can we get back the crackers again by using pollution and heat?
No.
Next. Spoilage of food. In summer mainly we face this problem.
Yes,
if you cook even in the morning, it will not be good till 4 o'clock or 5 o'clock. Why? Due to more heat, what is happening? The food will be spoiled. Now, if we spoil food, if we keep in the fridge, will it again become good?
No.
That means it is a chemical change. Here, you get a smell or bad smell from the food and food becomes very tasteless. That means this is a chemical reaction. The chemical reaction is taking place. Understood everyone? Chemical reaction also?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Two substances combine to form a new substance. It is called as
chemical change.
And the things which are going in, the substances which are involved in the chemical reaction are called as
reactants.
Due to reactants, we are getting one substance. No, the substance which undergo chemical reaction, which will be there in the chemical reaction, they are called as
reactants.
Reactants. Clear everyone?
Yes, ma'am.